Welcome to Video Workbench. The kind people over at Gravity Colors sent me a few samples to try out for this video review. Never heard of Gravity Colors? I'll try them out right here, let you know what I think of them, and let you know if I think they're a good buy for you to spend your hard-earned cash on. Without further ado, let's get to the review. Gravity Colors is a company that was established in 2013 in Europe to supply plastic scale model builders with premium quality automotive paints, making it possible to paint car models with the exact color shade that was used in the factory by the car manufacturer. Their United States office is located in Delray Beach, Florida. All paints cost $6.75, and special sets go from $13.50 to $22.50. Custom colors can also be ordered. Just go to gravitycolors.com to email them your request. Gravity Color paints are solvent-based lacquer-based coats, pre-thinned for airbrush use only. Their paints have a fast dry time, no fading, and excellent coverage, which makes it very easy to work with. Gravity Color paints come in three types: solid, metallic, and pearlescent colors. Solid paints have no sparkle effects like metallic and pearl effect colors. Metallic paints contain aluminum flakes to create a sparkling effect. Gravity Colors use the smallest metal flakes available in the industry to create the pearl paint solution for small-scale car models. Other paint manufacturers use medium to large-scale metal flakes in their paints that creates an out-of-scale finish when applied to car models in 1/24th scale or smaller. Gravity Color paints are pre-thinned for airbrush use, so you don't need to thin their paints. They are thinned to a consistency which is perfect for airbrushing. You can purchase additional thinners for their paints on their website. Gravity Color paints are solvent-based, which work the best with a primer that seals the plastic and creates a surface for the paint to adhere to. Gravity Color's Microfiller Primer is perfect for plastic, resin, and metal. For professional results, always use a primer on your scale model car kits. Gravity Color paints can be stripped using brake fluid or rubbing alcohol without damaging the model plastic body. Just submerge your model in a small container filled with brake fluid or alcohol and leave the model in it for a couple of days. The paint will get separated from the plastic. Make sure you clean and dry the model completely before you repaint it. Gravity Color's base coat paints dry flat. They require clear coating if your goal is to achieve a high gloss finish on your model. Gravity Color's clear coat solutions are available on their website. I suggest using a transfer pipette or painting dropper to fill your airbrush cup with paint. You can buy pipettes on their website. You can clean your airbrush with airbrush cleaner, regular lacquer thinner, or acetone. Ultrasonic cleaners do a great job cleaning airbrush parts of their paints. Gravity Color paints do not have any expiration date. However, thinner in the paint can evaporate over time, but you can always add more thinner to restore the paint viscosity to its original state. Make sure you always keep the paint bottle tightly closed. Put the bottle cap back on immediately when not in use and keep your paint in a cool, dry place. Now that all the information about who Gravity Colors is and the products they provide has been discussed, it's time to review the five samples they sent me. Surface Primer, Mercedes-Benz Fire Engine Red, 60s and 70s Golf Orange, Aston Martin Silver Fox, and their two-part single-dose clear gloss. For this review, I used my Iwata Revolution CR airbrush hooked up to an Iwata PowerJet compressor set at 20 PSI. Because these paints are solvent-based lacquer, please remember to wear a protective breathing mask and have an exhaust fan running at all times. Since these paints are formulated to be airbrush ready, all you have to do is shake them thoroughly and transfer the paint with a pipette to your airbrush. For this review, I have three scraps of plastic as my test subjects. I'll start off with the surface primer. After letting sit for a couple of hours, the surface primer is dry and, by what I see, adhere to the plastic quite well. Next up, we'll be airbrushing on the first color, Mercedes-Benz Fire Engine Red. After that, 60s and 70s Gulf Orange. And last, Aston Martin Silver Fox. I let all three colors dry for a day. I come back and mix the two-part single dose clear gloss and apply. Please be aware that I decided to put on heavy coats of the clear gloss to test to see if it would sag and or run, and positioned all three test pieces in an upright position. I let the clear gloss dry for a couple days before handling. Now that the testing has been done, what are my thoughts? I'm very impressed with the ease of use. Not having to use a reducer or thinner to thin the paint for airbrush use is very welcomed. Just having to shake the bottle for a minute to make sure the paint is properly mixed is a fast and painless process. Both the primer and paint don't clog the airbrush, nor are there any issues with tip dry. They flow out of the airbrush smooth and without issue. The paint laid down onto the plastic I airbrushed it on very well. It didn't pool, streak, blotch, or run. Once on the plastic, it started to dry almost immediately as I was applying it, so the drying time is rather fast. Once dry, it's very smooth and durable, which is quite different and a welcome surprise comparatively to other more well-known paints that have been around for quite some time. The two-part gloss coat was easy to mix, which as you saw, was done by just shaking the bottle. Much like their paints, the gloss coat didn't clog the airbrush or cause tip dry. Once applied, and after about an hour, the gloss coat became hard, durable, and had a great shine to it. Lastly, it did not run or sag, even when in an upright position when left to dry. Here are 5 points I think some modelers may have an issue with. When mixing the two-part gloss coat, I had a difficult time getting what I believe to be the activator out of the thin bottle. I couldn't squeeze the bottle to get the liquid out, so I had to become a little inventive and slide a toothpick in and out of the opening several times, pushing the air bubble trapped inside up until the liquid was completely out and into the larger bottle. A lot of people are most likely going to have an issue about the fast drying time of the paints. Please keep in mind that at the time I made this video review, it was pretty warm in my studio. So I'm sure that added to the fast drying time as well. But as I was applying the paint, I could actually see it drying right before my eyes, which for me is great, as I personally like a fast drying paint. Fast drying means I can keep working on the parts I want without long periods of wait time in between. The actual cleanup can be a bit of a chore. I found out through testing that leaving the paint sit for too long in the airbrush cup lets the paint dry, allowing it to adhere to the metal, making for a tougher cleanup. So what I suggest is once you are done with a color or clear coat, make sure you dispose of either one and put in your choice of airbrush cleaner immediately. I use Createx brand airbrush cleaner and let sit in the cup for a few minutes. When I came back, there was an oil and water effect that had taken place. Let me explain. Both the paint and gloss coat had a reaction to the cleaner and they both balled up on the inside of the cup and started to float in the cleaning liquid. Also, the cleaning liquid did not change to the color of the paint like most other cleaning liquids do during this process. Make sure between colors to give the airbrush a very thorough cleaning. Otherwise, you may have issues with the next color getting contaminated or the operation of your airbrush being limited the next time you use it. In concerns with the two-part single dose clear coat, make sure you're going to use all of it. If you don't, when you go back to the bottle, you'll find that it's become a rubbery solid. This in turn wastes what's left in the bottle, so please keep that in mind. Lastly, it's advertised on the Gravity Colors website that their paint dries flat. I found that all three colors I tested dried with a semi-gloss sheen, so please be aware of this small discrepancy. In closing, I would highly recommend Gravity Colors primers, paints, and clear coat products. All are very easy to use and are very durable. Please keep in mind that I believe these paints are formulated for more of an experienced modeler who has a few years under their belt dealing with more advanced paint systems. I personally like the faster drying time, some may not, though I think it's just a matter of personal preference. You don't have to add reducers or thinners for airbrush use. Just shake the bottle, use a pipette to transfer the paint into your airbrush cup, and spray. There's no fear of clogging or tip dry. Make sure to thoroughly clean your airbrush between colors and don't let the paint sit in the cup for too long. Otherwise, your cleanup time will be longer than it should be, as their products adhere real good to metal. If you would like to order their products or have any questions, go to their website at gravitycolors.com.